This wasn't a normal hurt.
What do you mean?
When they passed us by, we could hear them. They were whispering to each other.
Hey everybody, it's Charlie. This is going to be my Walking Dead mid-season finale video. Still a lot of really big questions about what happened in that six-year time gap after we last saw Rick Grimes. There were a couple really key WTF moments though. There's a new round of that IMAX ticket giveaway. All you have to do to enter is be a subscriber and write your favorite WTF moment from the episode on the video. So starting with number 5, we'll just hit like the really big WTF moments. It's 6 years later, none of the survivors are still talking to each other. Things have gotten really worse between the different communities, especially the core survivors. Maggie has officially bailed, but it's because Lauren Cohan has left the show. But they did it in a way that would allow her to come back a little bit easier than it would be for Rick Grimes, because Andrew Lincoln is like, I am definitely not coming back to the TV show. But if you're holding out hope for Rick Grimes, remember they're doing those Rick Grimes movies. You could see something way down the road. Never say never, but when Andrew Lincoln left, he really did make it sound like he never planned on coming back to the proper TV show. But I think that the producers are going to try to do whatever they can, throw as much money as possible at him to get him to come cameo again. The reason that Lauren Cohan left the show was more because of a pay dispute. That was actually a pretty public battle that she was in with the network for a while. So that is the reason why Maggie is no longer around, is because Lauren Cohan wanted more money. They didn't want to give it to her. So she made a pilot for another TV show, and that TV show was picked up to series. So she's a character on like a whole different network on another show. So she's busy doing that. Within the world of the show, though, she took Herschel and went with Georgie's group, leaving a note. Love the way she peaced out. She just totally left a note and bailed on everyone. Like, see ya, peace, I'm out of here. When you say a character is far, far away from where they are right now, it just means that you probably won't see them for several episodes. Maybe we'll see a cameo from her in the finale or the next time that they bring Georgie's group back. But you have to imagine it's 6 years later. They're using that as an opportunity to peel off a lot of the old characters that they want to either get rid of or the actors that want to move on to other things and leave the TV show, like Andrew Lincoln. 4, Michonne has given birth to Rick's son, who they've named Rick Jr., or RJ for short. Pretty big deal, obviously not a big comic book thing, but I think it's just a way to keep Rick on the show as much as possible to remind people that he's such a big force even though he's not around anymore. Like, I don't know that it was necessary because they went through that whole arc of him reconciling that Judith was really Shane's son. They even had a big moment like that when they brought Shane back to the TV show for the flashback that Rick was having when he was hallucinating as he was slowly bleeding out. I think for some reason the showrunners want to keep a baby on the show just because it makes it more relatable. Like, oh, they're trying to be a family, and it's easier to do that when you see someone having to care for a child, like a really small helpless child, and also wield a katana at the same time. So it helps them with the Michonne character because she's had such a radical personality change that now she's almost like back to the original version of Michonne when we met her at the end of season 3. Like, wielding katanas, using walker camo, just a total Terminator walking through the apocalypse. But the thing that a lot of people are just paying attention to is the fact that she's not willing to help people as much. She's much more closed off. She doesn't trust anyone. She has that mysterious giant scar on her back that they haven't explained yet. There's just a lot of shit that went down during that 6 year period, but the baby, the RJ baby, helps humanize her a little bit more. So you sympathize with her, even though for some strange reason, she did something that made all the other core survivors hate her now. 3, Judith, of course, is the new Carl Grimes circa season 2, season 3. Still pretty young, but old enough to wield a gun pretty handily and defend herself when she's traveling alone short distances and sass everyone. Precocious young girl in the Walking Dead universe. I think they're trying to evoke a lot of Clementine with her character. And if you're really sad about all the fallout with Telltale Games and them not being able to finish the Walking Dead game, Skybound, Robert Kirkman's company that produces all of his comics and media, everything, it's his big media empire, has bought the rights to that, and they're going to try and finish the Walking Dead video game with Clementine. No real word or ETA about how that's going to go down, but they're trying to hire a bunch of people from Telltale to finish that. But on the TV show, it just seems like Judith is meant to be the Clementine, like the really young girl hardcore protagonist that comes of age in a more main role than someone like Enid, because Enid was around, but I wouldn't really call the way they set her up or the way they write her as badass. And now, because of the 6 year time jump, she's way older, so it doesn't work quite as well because she's not a little girl anymore. But a really big one, number 2, Father Gabriel lets Negan escape, and not only on purpose, like the door's just open. I love the way he just whistles and walks at like, no big deal, just gonna leave. Obviously, this is a big comic book thing with him getting away. He has a big arc with the Whispers coming up, so maybe they'll do a lot of comic book Negan stuff. but we don't really know what the show's plans are for him short term, because a lot of the Negan Whisperer stuff in the comics doesn't happen till way later on, and they just introduced them. So the first order of the day is the main group realizing what's going on with these evolved walkers, as Eugene says, like the title of the episode was Evolution, because he literally thinks that the walkers are evolving. Surprise, surprise, no, they're just taking walker camo to its next logical step over what Michonne used to do. Carrying them around on chains, now they're wearing walker skins. But man, Father Gabriel, after that 6-year time jump, it seemed like he had a stable relationship going on. It seemed like he wasn't such a douchebag anymore, but you knew that couldn't last for too long. Like, there are a couple characters that are like the whipping bags of the Walking Dead TV show, and Gabriel has been one of them the last several seasons. So right now, I think that Eugene is probably just happy that it's not him anymore. He actually seems a lot more stable than he was in previous seasons. People hated him so much after he went to the Saviors. Toxic fans in real life shamed the actor Josh McDermott off of social media after all those big Eugene twists when he seemingly had gone over to Negan. That totally sucks. So I think that's why they're trying to write him in a more useful way. Like, he's more integral to the group. He's not making as many boneheaded mistakes. But you always gotta have that one person that does that really stupid thing. And it seems like Negan has chilled out in the intervening 6 years, like he was meditating with Gabriel, because it seems like whatever mental problems he was having when Maggie was confronting him before the 6-year time jump, he's past that. But obviously, number one, WTF, we have to talk about this. The Whisperers killing Jesus, sacrificing him to the meat grinder of the TV show for ratings purposes. Within the context of the show, the justification that the showrunner gave is that she wanted to take away a big trump card that Hilltop had. Like, it had to feel like a really big loss, and they spent most of the early part of the episode with Aaron telling him, you would be an amazing leader if you just got up off your ass, and he's one of the most skilled, knowledgeable people that they have, so he would be really awesome as a leader. So what do? Before you introduce a really hardcore new challenge for the group, you take away some of their advantages. The Whisperer who stabbed him told him before he died, you're where you don't belong. So it's just implying that they're encroaching on the Whisperer's territory. That's where their conflict will start. And I don't think this is going to happen with any of the Rick Grimes A, B stuff where he was being taken to another group, like she had been passing people on to this other group as A's or B's. But I do think they were foreshadowing the alpha beta of the Whisperers, even though technically I think this group that Rick has gone on to is a completely different place. There were a couple notable comic book moments, like with Negan getting out because someone left his cell open. In the comics, it was actually combined from a couple different places. It was Olivia that left his cell door open in issue number 140, but he doesn't actually leave till issue 152. When they get attacked by the Whisperers in the graveyard, that's from issue 132. Also, when they find someone in the barn. In the TV show, it was Eugene. In the books, it was Dante. Same basic twist. The scene where Daryl unmasks the Whisperer at the end of the episode is also from the end of issue number 132, but it was Dante that rips the mask off. But everybody, let me know in the comments, what was your favorite WTF moment? What do you think of the show now that they've changed it so much? Like, we have Magna's group, Rick is gone, Maggie is gone. Judith is kind of their Clementine now, so it's very, very different, but I think some things for the better, obviously some things for the worse. It's just weird not having Carl, not having Rick Grimes. It almost doesn't feel like The Walking Dead, but I think they're trying to do what they can to keep the show going. So what'll happen is there's an Avengers video that I'm finishing that I'll post a little bit later. There's a new Arrow episode tonight, so just look for those top pinned comments, and as long as you have alerts enabled, you should see all my videos. Click here for that new Black Suit Superman trailer for the big Flash Arrow crossover, and click here for my brand new Captain Marvel trailer video. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.